What's up, everybody? Let's talk about runes. Let's talk about runes, and let's talk about where some of these Looney Toonies. Let's talk about where some of these rune combinations can be useful. Cause, ooh yeah, and you can see my new Dragon's B10. It's not my new Dragon's B10 team. It's just a different. I wanted to try a different Dragon's B10 team. Cause why not? Let's have some fun. You guys can see something a little different than what I've used before. I always like to mix it up, you know what I'm saying. Because there's like 9,000 different teams you could develop for Dragon's B10, right? So I figured that would be good. So let's look at the different rune sets. We got the Fatal, we got the Endure, we got the four sets first. We'll switch the runes around like this. We have the four set on the left and the two set on the right. We'll go over some of the monsters that that these sets can be good for. Fatal Endure, we're starting strong, Fatal Endure. Fatal is a good beginner set for a lot of your attackers, right? Now, Fatal is also good for bombers. I wouldn't say Fatal Endure for bombers. I have Fatal Endure on my Katarina is the only monster that I think I have Fatal Endure on. That's just because I had good Endure runes and I was like, you know what? I'll put Fatal Endure on her. I have my Good Rage runes on my Lucian and my Tashar, so Katarina gets the Fatal ones. But Fatal is usually used for end game, is still used for bombers. But early game is used because you get Fatal runes early game easier than you get the Rage runes. And for many monsters, they're interchangeable as long as you know you can get good runes. Lucian, you can use Fatal or Rage. Katarina, you could use Fatal or Rage. A lot of your other attackers, you can use your strong attackers. You can use Fatal or Rage. There's some exceptions to that rule. For example, Sigmaris does damage based on enemy's max HP with his third skill. So, better to have Sigmaris on Rage. He does more damage that way, just because of what it's based on. You know what I mean, Jellybean? So we have that better for Rage. But Fatal Endure, we're talking about Fatal Endure now. Good for attacker. Endure really not used too much with the Fatal. Really not a common combination. What do we have next? Fatal Revenge. Again, another thing you could use Katarina, because if you Revenge, or you could use it with an attacker that's got a defense break on the first skill. Usually Revenge is not used too much with things like Ramagos. Ramagos, of course, decreases attack gauge with his first skill, so if you Revenge on him, the attack gauge is not going to go anywhere, because whatever monster just hit you doesn't have, we don't need to decrease their attack gauge, right? Okay. Now I'm going off topic now. Fatal Revenge, not used too much, but at least better than Fatal Endure usually. Fatal Nemesis, again, not used too much. Maybe if you have good Nemesis runes with good substats, then you could put those on there. Fatal Shield. A lot of these things I'm like, Katarina, but not really. Attackers that have good high base HP can benefit more from the shield runes than as a two set. But a lot of you really want to, Blade or Will. And now we get to Will. Okay, but Fatal is usually used for bombers. Now we get to Will. Will is, a lot of people use this for Arena offense and Guild Wars offense, as they use Will, even for their attackers. Like, let's say you have a Lucian. Let's say you have, why do I keep going with Lucian? There's a million other attackers. Let's say you have a Zeros, you want to use Zeros, and you want him to be a Nuke Zeros, right? And you got you could use Fatal Will for your Nuke Zeros, your Nuke Hell Lady. You have that Will rune so that maybe you don't have a speed team, you don't get the first turn advantage. Your opponents get the first turn advantage, but you guys don't get stunned or anything because you have those Will runes. So Fatal Will is good for, Fatal Will is good in the same place that Rage Will is good for, your Nuke monsters, Tashar, things like that. Things are just hoping to get a Galleon in there, or any defense break and attack buff monsters, and you have a full Will team with shield. So that's where you can use Fatal Will. Fatal Will, usually not in dungeon teams. Really doesn't give you much benefit in dungeon teams. It's good for arena offense. Fatal Will, not so much for defense, but Fatal Will for offense is used. Okay, then we have Fatal Destroy. Again, attackers, Destroy is a two set. Not too many people using them, but you can rune some of your monsters. But if you get good Destroy runes, why not? Why not? Fatal Destroy actually works pretty well, as long as you have good enough crit rate. works pretty well because it doesn't work for bombers though. So don't put your Fatal Destroy on your bombers. But if you have regular attackers, Fatal Destroy, do the damage. Fatal, usually your monster's doing a lot of damage. Destroy, you're gonna destroy some of that the damage they took. You're gonna destroy some of their HP. Oh my god. Jubail, you're talking too much. Okay, Fiddle Guard, really not used. Really not used. Fatal Blade, very common. We should have just gone with Blade first. Why didn't we go with Blade first? Very common, the most common early game nuker farmer rune set, because you get the Fatal Blade runes the easiest in the beginning of the game, right? So that is the most common, and there's nothing wrong with going Fatal Blade. If you have better Fatal runes than Rage runes, there's nothing wrong with going Fatal before, like instead of going Rage. I remember when I first started playing the game, I was using Fatal Blade Lucian, and everyone's like, no, do Rage Blade Lucian, do Rage Blade, Rage Blade, Lucian sucks with Fatal, make him Rage. And there was more of a difference back then with Fatal and Rage. But still, I would take him off Fatal and put him on Rage, and I'm like, he got worse. But everyone's telling me to put him on Rage. But he got worse. As long as you have the stats there, as long as you have big numbers on stats, big chunky numbers on stats, then Fatal Blade, Rage Blade, whatever is the best combination for you to do the most damage. Then we have Fatal Focus. Fatal Focus is a really good combination for bombers because bombs need accuracy. Bombs are based on attack power. They need accuracy to make sure that they stick, like this. Why am I keep doing that? They need the accuracy to make sure they stick on the monsters. So Fatal Focus is a common rune build for your bombers. Attack, attack, attack. Some people do speed attack, attack. I haven't tried it. Fatal Energy. It's really just Fatal Energy is not bad. It's an early game combination, but not really used too much later on. Later on, okay, so we're back to Endure now. Okay. What's the next one? We have Vampire. Vampire Endure. Vampire Endure. Who could this be good on? Vampire is usually used for farm. Well, it's used for farming monsters. Some people like to use their Trevor on Vampire. I don't think Vampire Endure is the best combination. If you have really good Endure runes, yeah, but Vampire Endure really isn't a strong combination. Vampire Revenge. This could work, though. This could work. You have a vampire monster. Every time they take damage, they don't revenge every time, but they take damage, they'll revenge, they'll counter, and they'll heal themselves up back when they revenge. This is a common combination with things like Trevor. I think I see Vampire Revenge more than anything else. So we get it. And then we have Vampire Nemesis, another common. This is actually works really good with Vampire. You take damage, your HP gets low, and then you get another turn faster so that you can do more damage and then get your HP back. So yes, and also some of these, we see some of the Dragon Knights with Vampire Nemesis. Vampire Nemesis, I think I have Vampire, I do have Vampire Nemesis on my Trevor. Okay, what is next? But they're mainly for attackers. Mainly, not always. I know my guildmate Tub has a Vampire Shield. Really is not a thing. We're not gonna go over the things that really are not a thing. Vampire Will, really not a thing. Vampire Destroy. Maybe it's got some uses somewhere, but really not a huge thing. Vampire Guard. I was gonna say about my guildmate Tub. He uses Vampire Guard on his copper for farming. So he can farm his copper's defense, 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 or defense, crit damage, defense, and uses Vampire Guard. And it's really hard to do damage to the copper, and then the copper just ignores defense and gets all that HP back. And it's nice. It's a farming build for copper. But it's not like a super nuke build. Rage Guard copper would do more damage, but at least this is something for farming for copper. Can do that. Vampire Blade again. Things like the Dragon Knights, things like Trevor, work good with that. Vampire Focus. Vampire Focus for a monster that does good damage, but also has debuffs on him as well. I do have a monster Vampire Focus. It's not my first choice of runes for him, but I do have Vampire Focus on my Dark Warbear. I just had it on to... I put it on there to try to see if he could be good at farming and at 4-star. And he did do hell levels at 4-star. But, and he's got debuffs on all three of his skills, so that's why Vampire Focus. Alright, then we have Vampire Energy. Things like Ramagas, Vampire Energy, for people who like to build their Ramagas. And some people say, Ramagas, I haven't seen too much of him lately. I haven't. Then again, I haven't used too much of him lately, just because Chasun is, like, the most popular wind tank now, too. So, not too many Ramagas is still in play. But... Ramagas is still amazing. I still love Ramagas. And another reason is because there's so many Orions in Arena. Ramagas can't really use him too as much as you used to be able to use him when you're like, oh yeah, they're just gonna take a Zeros and a Perna and a Veladrule and just have all fire anti-Lucian defense. Okay, I'll just take my Ramagas. But it's not like that like it used to be. Some people like using Violent Ramagas. Some people like using Vampire Ramagas. I personally have Vampire... I think I have Vampire Energy on my Ramagas. Vampire Energy or Vampire Nemesis. Vampire Endure... Oh, we already went... We already went over that. Alright, what do we have? Despair Endure. Okay. Despair Endure could be good for... Despair is usually used for monsters that have AoE. So, what do we have? What do we have for Despair? I like to use it on monsters that have, like, right now I have my Dark Serpent that we're using right here. He's got Despair. He's got double AoEs, and he's got a cleanse on his, not a cleanse. He's got harmful. He's got beneficial effect removal on his first skill. But he's got Despair. We can't stun the dragon, of course, so we don't get to see too much of the Despair. This team is actually doing not too bad. Sometimes we get hit by a lot of damage from that left tower, though, because we accidentally will kill it occasionally. But it's doing pretty good. We do have two beneficial effect removers. We have the Serpent and we have the Werewolf. But Despair, back to the runes, like we're supposed to be doing. Despair is usually used for monsters that have two AoEs. Despair is also used sometimes for monsters that revenge. So I know the Light Archangel, some people put him on Despair. They like to use him on Despair. It's actually, if you see some of those Despair Archangels, it can get annoying. They can just stun your entire team, like, just with counters. Stun. Oh my god. Some people like to use the Despair with the Wind Monkey King too. I like to use Despair with monsters that have multiple AoEs, area of effect skills, and Despair is fantastic for TOA. So we have Despair Endure. Despair Endure usually is not a big thing. We have Despair Revenge. But if you want to do Despair Endure, Endure is usually good for healers and revivers, because you don't want them to get crowd controlled, you don't want them to get debuffed, to get speed broken, to get stunned, frozen, whatever. So Despair Endure can be good for things like, for example, Bryand could be good for Despair Endure. Okay, then we have Despair Revenge. Despair Revenge is actually pretty good. Like I said, my Dark Serpent is on Despair Revenge. Did I say he was on Revenge too? Yes, he is on Revenge. I don't know if I said it or not, but he is. But Despair Revenge is good, because when you revenge, you have a chance to stun them as well. Another thing for Despair is a lot of cleansers. People like to put cleansers on Despair. So things like Aquila, who's going to cleanse is his second skill the cleanse or his third skill? I don't remember which skill it is that his cleanse is. It's his third skill, right? But anyway, then we have Praha, Juno, usually on Despair. Usually on Despair Revenge a lot, too. Because they can increase their attack gauge when they with their first skill. So they like to do the revenge and Despair, of course, because they cleanse. They're monsters that cleanse. They get so ridiculous annoying. Some of these Despair Prahas and Junos, because you can get a better chance to have that Despair activate if you know for a fact that the enemy team is getting cleansed too. So if they don't have any immunity, you know that there's a good chance for them to get stunned. Alright, so we got Despair Revenge on those. A lot of times, like I said, Juno, Praha, Aquila, who else? Let's see. Well, Bryand. Okay, then who do we have next? Despair Nemesis. Actually, another thing that's common with Praha and Juno is Despair Nemesis. With the AoEs. Despair Shield. Not too common. You could still use it, but it's not as strong usually as the Despair Nemesis and Despair Revenge. Then we have Will. Despair Will. You could do, if you're gonna do your cleansers and things like that with Will, it's really for Will is again for arena offense and defense. Despair Destroy, really don't see that too much. Despair Guard, really don't see that too much. Sometimes if you get really good guard runes or whatever. Despair Blade, you could still do this on something like an Oracle. You could still do the Despair Blade because, I mean, for lower level, I guess, if you don't have as amazing Revenge or Nemesis runes, you can still do Despair Blade. This way, they keep critting with their first skill. So that's nice, because they do benefit from the extra crit. And then I do believe the Undines, Despair Revenge is good, because they have, some of the Undines have AoE skills, so Despair Blade is not bad on some of the Undines, the ones that have the AoEs, area of effect skills. We have Despair Focus, actually a pretty common combination too, because a lot of times crowd control monsters will be Despair Focus, monsters like Arya the Light Succubus, because Arya has Focus is for accuracy, for increasing your accuracy for your monsters. So, things like Arya the Light Succubus, oh my god, I'm getting like parched. Things like Arya the Light Succubus, do you maybe talk less or slower or something? Arya the Light Succubus has crowd control with all three of her skills. So she's got the area of effect skill with her third skill. And then she's got the sleep and the stun with her first and second skills. So, yeah, we got the despair because she's got the AoE, she's got the area of effect skill. And then we have focus because she's got debuffs on all three of her skills. So you can do that. Also, same thing with, oh my god, we're getting amazing rune drops today. Same thing with Bryand. Since he has, you could do it with him. He's got the attack break. Maybe you want a reliable attack break and you got good focus runes. Despair Focus also for Beretta. Beretta is a good monster because we got those. Beretta a lot of times is on Despair. My Beretta personally is on Despair. He's got the crowd control, the AoE with the stunnies. With Despair he's got the stunnies, but he's got the dots. Focus because we want to get those dots on, and we want to also decrease the attack age of the enemy. So Beretta is usually Despair Focus. There's really not a lot of people that do Despair Revenge on Beretta, just because Despair Focus is a little bit stronger because you want those debuffs to stick, especially when you're on TOA hard and you're like, I really need to decrease the attack age to zero of this boss. That focus comes in handily. The focus comes in handily. We have Despair Energy. You could use it on the same monsters, but it's just like an earlier game combination. Then we have, okay, so we're back to Endure. Okay, what's next? Violent. Oh god, hold on. We gotta take a drink before this. Okay, so we got Violent. Violent Endure, usually used for revivers. Revivers, healers, mostly revivers though, Violent Endure. Things like Archangel, Ladriel, Vanessa, things like that. Usually rune for Violent Endure. Sometimes they're different. Sometimes you see some Vanessas that are rune for attack, which is nice. Some people, it really depends on your playstyle. If you like to, or it, also it depends on if you're using speed offense. Like a few times I've considered switching my Vanessa to attack because if I'm gonna use her for offense, it's gonna be a lot more beneficial if I can start actually killing things with Vanessa too. She got a little bit of attack on her, but not as much as I'd like. But mine is on Violent Endure. Also, my Archangel's on Violent Endure. Usually revivers are on Endure because you want them to get their revives as much as possible. That's why the Violent runes, so they have a lot of access to their revives. Iona too. Iona could be Violent Endure. So we got that. What is next? Violent Revenge. Oh my god, Violent Revenge. So Violent Revenge, actually, this Vertiheal right here is Violent Revenge. Who else is Violent Revenge? You could put, man, any monster that's got really good either passives or first skills, like monkeys, monkey kings, that have Violent Revenge. I mean, you could, we could talk all day about Violent Revenge. Violent Revenge could be on any, like, almost any monster. There's just so many uses for Violent Revenge. I would say Vertiheal is great for Violent Revenge. My Basalt is on Violent Focus. We'll get to that. But my Basalt is on Focus because I want him to get be very, very accurate with his attack age decrease. But he could be Revenge because he does Provoke, which is kind of nice. So any monster that's got a really, really good first skill or really, really good passive, like Vertiheal's passive is amazing with Revenge. Well, if you Revenge a lot. If you Revenge a lot. But that's Violent Revenge. There's so many times Violent Revenge can be useful. For what are those monsters? Beast monks. Where do we begin Violent Revenge? Oh my god. So yeah, Violent Revenge, like half the monsters in the game are great on Violent Revenge. Okay, next one, Violent Nemesis. Violent Nemesis is usually used for healers. Things like Chasun, maybe Bella. Violent Nemesis is also really good on Varimoss. My Varimoss is on Violent Nemesis as well. This way his attack gauge goes, his health goes down when he gets hit, his attack gauge goes up, and then he can cleanse buffs when his attack gauge goes up. Not good for Violent Revenge as much, because when he revenges, he's not going to clear the debuffs on the team. He's only going to clear it when he gets a turn. So that's why I think Violent Nemesis is much better for Varimoss than Violent Revenge. But you could do Violent Nemesis also for Vertiheal too. So that's nice. But you a lot of times healers, cleansers, things like that, Nemesis. There's a lot of Nemesis. There's not a lot, but there's... Well, there kind of is a lot. When you get to higher levels, there kind of is a lot of Nemesis traps for arena defense. So you start getting hit, and then the Nemesis triggers, and then your team gets a turn, and then you can either crowd control the opponent, or you can get a big heal off, like with Praha or Chasun or something like that. But Violent Nemesis is usually used for healers. Healers. You can also use a... I think I mentioned that you can use a... You can do Bella Violent Nemesis too. Okay, Violent Shield. Violent Shield, I contemplated putting my... Do we want that? We'll keep that for now. I was waiting for it to be like, you are out of space. I contemplated switching my Orion to Violent Shield, because Orion at least has over 10,000 base hit points, and it would at least maybe good. I saw a Violent Nemesis Orion, and I was like, oh, that's cool. I was like, that's doing really good actually. So I kind of like the Violent Nemesis Orion. A lot of people do Violent Will Orion for arena and for guild battles too. But I thought the Violent Shield was interesting. The thing about the Violent Nemesis Orion, let's talk about the Violent Nemesis Orion, is it works similar to Vertiheal. Starts taking some hits. I know we got the shield on, but shield is good for tanky monsters, right? For tanky monsters that are gonna help give that extra wall of protection for a lot of times arena defense. Arena defense or Guild Wars defense, etc., etc. So for that brutal first hit that you get to survive at least until turn two. So we have, we were talking about Violent Nemesis for Orion. Violent Nemesis for Orion is nice. Let's say you Lucian, right? Let's say you're facing an Orion team. It's like HP leader, and then you have an Orion like Varimoss, blah, blah, Orion. And you go in for the double Lucian. You Lucian the first one, and then the Nemesis triggers, and Orion gets his turn next, and then he uses his harmless prank, and... You know, starts debuffing your team, and then pushes up the attack age of all the enemies, and then they get their turns, similar to the way the healer, you know, the way it works for the healers, but Violent Nemesis can work with Orion, can work with different monsters like that that will increase the attack age of the whole team as well. So things that'll heal the whole team, things that'll increase the attack age of the whole team. also. We have Violent Will. I mean, Violent Will is big for defense. Big for defense in... Because Violent seems like a trigger. It doesn't seem like it triggers. We already did the math on it. It actually does trigger more on defense than it does on offense. So we already did the math on it. Violent Will is good for guild battle defense, for arena defense. Because Violent just goes crazy sometimes. It goes crazy. And Violent Will stops, unless you're... Unless someone's going in with a cleanser expecting Will and Shield runes, it can stop someone from nuking with Galleon and whatever else they plan on nuking with, whatever their strong AoE attacker is. So it can stop that first round of debuffs. So yes, it's pretty much just it's really not for dungeons or TOA. It's really just for defense in guild battles and arena. Or offense sometimes, but usually rage, will, things like that for offense, not really so much. There's some monsters that are Violent Will for offense, but there's not the... It's more for defense. It seems more on defense. And we have Violent Destroy. We're really not seeing so much Destroy right now. I really should build a Destroy team and start playing with it. And then we have Violent Guard. Violent Guard. What could Violent Guard be good for? Basically the same, like, healers and stuff like that. I'm trying to think off the top of my head what... it's just the same as Violent Endure. Same as Violent Energy. Just healers. Healers, revivers, things like that. That you want a lot of tankiness on. Then we have Violent Blade. Violent Blade, sometimes seen in early game Theomars. No! I like Theomars with Violent Will, though. I think that the best Theomars are the ones that give me the most trouble are in Violent Will. But we have Violent Blade, really for things like for attackers that you want to go crazy and attack multiple times, like Theomars. Damn you, Theomars. But maybe for early game Theomars, just to get that extra violent, just to get that extra crit rate on. You could also do Violent Blade for things like Vertiheal as well, if you don't have a high crit rate with the revenge, because revenge is only a small chance too. So I mean, it's nice to have, but if you have better blade runes, then ain't nothing but a thing. Then we have Violent Focus, monsters that you want to attack a lot and also have debuffs. So like this is on, he's on Violent Focus, this Basalt, you just saw him violent, and he also decreased the attack gauge. Very good with the focus. We already went over that, right? Oh, also, things like Orion too. Like we were talking about Orion. Just focus always good for things with debuffs. DBDB debuffs. And then we have Violent Energy. Same thing as the Reviver's healers. Okay, what's next? Swift. Oh, Swift. This should be an easy one. Okay, Swift Endure. Swift is really just used for things. There's mostly one or two different Swift sets. It's Swift Will and Swift and whatever else gets you a really, really lot of speed. Swift is for Chloe, Swift is for Bernard, Swift is for any monster that's gonna increase your attack age. Some people use Orion on Violent, some people use Orion on Swift. Swift is for that monster that you need to attack first, get their turn first. So, like I said, Orion will increase the attack age, Bernard will increase the attack age and increase the speed. Swift Endure, really it's just for monsters. Also monsters that have damage based on their speed. Swift Endure, not so much used. I have it on my Chloe, one of my Chloes. I have Swift Endure. I just couldn't get the same stuff on Will, so I have him on Swift Endure. Swift Revenge. Swift Revenge you can put on... You can put on Hua, but with the revenge, remember Hua's passive is going to decrease attack age. So if we revenge, it's really not going to do much because it's going to do still damage, but it's not going to decrease the attack age because of course the enemies, it's their turn already, you know? So Swift Revenge, we have Swift Nemesis. Swift Nemesis is another thing that's good for monsters like Orion, monsters that will also increase the attack gauge. Swift Nemesis would not be bad on Chloe. let's say you want your monster to attack first, right? But someone else outspeeds you and starts doing damage, so the monsters take that damage, and then your nemesis kicks in and you're like, okay, Chloe, we took one blast of damage, let's fanatic and stop another blast of damage. Or swift nemesis on Bernard, okay, we took some damage and now Bernard reduces his health enough to get his turn, to boost his attack gauge up to get his turn, and then we can do our little wingy wingies and give everyone else their turn. Wingy wingies, tailwind, and give everyone else their turn next, and then we can nuke them back. So that's with Swift Nemesis, Swift Shield. You could do Swift Shield. Some people do Swift Shield, but it's really... Really, the thing with Swift is whatever two set will give you the most speed is the two set you're going to use. I mean, either that or Will. So, but Will, again, Swift Will for Arena, Guild Battles, Swift for something like PvE, the Kairos Dungeon, the Swift... Oh my god, are we gonna die? Oh no, we're gonna die! Oh no! No, we're not gonna die. We got this. But yeah, not so much Will on those. Swift Shield, really... You could use it sometimes, but there's better. But if you got really, really good speed, then by all means, if you got amazing shield runes, you got like 26 speed on them, then go ahead and go Swift Shield. And if Swift Will, we already talked about this, really, really good for especially Chloe's, things like that. Orion, people do Swift Will. Who else? Wind Polar Queen, Tiana. Is good for Swift Will. I think that basically covers it. Swift Will is a Chloe combination. If Swift Destroy, you can put it on. If you have amazing Destroy runes, you can put it on Hua because Hua does a good amount of damage. This I think Swift Destroy would be better on Hua than Swift Revenge. Swift Guard, if you have amazing speed on Guard, but it's really not a thing. Swift Blade. You could do, okay, so Swift Blade could be a thing for monsters that deal damage based on their attack speed, or monsters that deal damage based on their attack speed and also need to crit. For example, the Water Rakshasa needs to crit to do dots on her second skill. So Swift Blade is good on her because she's got a better chance to do her dots. Swift Blade, Swift Focus is good on her too. She does a better chance to do her dots with her second skill, because we need that high crit rate on that. What is next? So yeah, Rakshasas. You could do Swift Blade with whatchamacallit, with Chimeras too. Not all the Chimeras, some of the Chimeras, but they do damage based on their attack speed too. Some of them do. We have Swift Focus, like I said, again, Rakshasas. We could do Swift Focus. We could do Swift Focus on something like Orion. Man, I really should be talking about more monsters than just that. I feel like we'll go over some of my monsters too. Swift Energy, really, whatever you have. This is kind of an early game rune set, but if you have really good energy, I think my Bernard used to be on Swift Energy because I had good speed on the energy runes. Then we're back to Swift Endure. Okay, what's next? Rage? Okay. Rage Endure, really not a thing unless you have amazing Endure runes with like attack and crit rate and crit damage and speed and legendary Endure runes. Aside from that, really not a thing. It's usually Rage Blade. You usually need the crit rate, so everything is usually Rage Blade. Sometimes Rage Will. I've seen Rage Will on things like Xeros. Rage Revenge. Ooh, Rage Revenge. Rage Revenge could be good on things like Brandia could be good on Rage Revenge. A lot of people like to do massive damage with her third skill. I have my Brandia on Violent, but I know a lot of people like to do Rage with Brandia for that crazy damage numbers with her third skill. So Rage Revenge, because she does have a defense break on her first skill as well. What else would be good on Rage Revenge? The Wind Assassin would be good on Rage Revenge. Things that have do damage with their first skill and do defense breaks and things that you need, right? Rage Revenge. Okay. So, yeah. high damage dealing monsters. Also, Raid Revenge might be good for... Well, you also want them to at least be able to take a hit, right? You have Rage Nemesis. Really, I don't see Rage Nemesis too much. It's really not... If you have really good Nemesis runes, then by all means use that as a two set if you got a lot of crit damage, a lot of crit rate on it. Let's see what else. We have Rage Shield. Really not... I don't really see that as a thing. Rage Will. We talked about that. Your big damage nukers. I have Rage Will on my Tashar. I know a lot of people use... The people that have Xeros use Rage Will on their Xeros. I know people that have... I think that there's some people with Rage Will on the... God, we're getting some amazing runes today. Rage Will's on the... Rage Will's? Rage Will Smith on their... Alicia and their Hell Ladies, and I'm trying to think who else. Just big damage nukers, things that you want to use with Galleon for PvP. Rage Destroy. Rage Destroy is not bad. Not bad if you have good Destroy runes. Rage Destroy could save you a headache if you can't nuke them down and they still have their turn. At least you took some of their max HP away. You destroyed some of their max HP. I don't think that's bad. I think if you're going to use Destroy runes, Rage Destroy is a better combination than using Destroy on a healer. You really, that's not where you want to go. So Rage Destroy is one of the better Destroy combinations. Rage Guard. Rage Guard usually used for things like Copper. You can also do Basalt if you want to do a nuke Basalt. Some people like to do their Basalts as nukes. He does good damage, so it's actually fun using Basalt as a nuker. But Rage Guard is for monsters that do damage based on their defense, and they're critalicious. So definitely Copper. If you want to do Basalt as a nuker, Rage Guard is good for Basalt as a nuker. Lizardmen. I know some people that have Rage Guard Lizardmen, and they like them. I'm not really a fan of the Lizardmen, but I do know some people that have Rage Guard Lizardmen. So that's good for that. Rage Blade, of course, the number one Rage combination. Lucian and all that other nonsense, and Katarina, etc., etc., etc. Rage Blade. So, and of course, Rage Blade is the most used combination because you need, if you're gonna use Rage, you need that crit rate. If you don't have that crit rate, then the crit damage is really not useful. You're just rolling the dice, and most of the time it's gonna bite you in the ass. So, you really need that extra crit rate. What do we have next? We have Rage Focus. Rage Focus. Who? I do have a monster on Rage Focus. I do, and he's right here, Ashir. Ashir is on Rage Focus. HP, crit damage, HP. Because his massacre is based on his max HP. And then I'm always surprised he doesn't do more damage with the massacre. I mean, he does okay, but I'm always like, no, I wanted him to do so much more damage. I guess maxing out my light tower would help in that too. So yes, the reason he's focus is because massacre will remove beneficial effects. So I do want that damage on him, but I also want to make sure that we remove those beneficial effects. The reason I did that was I had him as a anti-Theomars. So I want to be able to do lethal damage, plus keep getting that chance to take that Endure off. Take damn Theomars Endure off. So that's why he's Rage Focus. But another thing, you can put the Dark Warbear on Rage Focus too. He's good on Rage Focus as well, because he's got, like I said, he's got debuffs with his third skill, but he can be used as a nuker, the Dark Warbear. We have Rage Energy, you could use Ashir as Rage Energy too, because Ashir, like I said, it's based on his max HP. And then we're back to Rage Endure, and then, oh, we're back to Fatal, oh my god, we're done, oh god, you guys sat through 40 minutes of Jubagel just talking about runes, for 40 minutes. Damn, congratulations, pat yourself on the back. You've just endured quite a bit. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it gave you a little bit more insight. It's really for newer players mostly. I think a lot of the older players, players that have been playing for a while already know all this stuff. But hopefully it helps at least some of the newer players be like, oh yeah, that's where I use that, that's where I use this, that's where I use the other thing. Cool, yeah, now I know, awesome. So I hope it does help you. 40 minutes of jibba jabba. I will see you guys, as always, in the next damn video where I talk way too long.